In this video, I will provide a brief overview of the Enterprise Analytics Reporting Tool in Editorial Manager. You may access reports from your editor main menu by clicking the Reports link located under the Administrative Functions heading found at the bottom of this page. Please contact your journal manager if you do not see this link and require account privileges to access reports. The Report Tools section provides you with additional resources to create your own customized reports to obtain information above and beyond what is available from the delivered reports. These reports are General Data Export, Custom Reports, and Enterprise Analytics Reporting. General Data Export allows you to extract raw data from Editorial Manager database in the form of tables. Custom reports, on the other hand, are pseudo tables that are created by combining two or more tables at the back end, allowing editors to create reports containing data from commonly viewed areas of the system. Enterprise Analytics Reporting is a combination of the General Data Export and the custom reports. Database Help contains a repository of all the tables and views that are available through the General Data Export and custom reports. Now, click on Enterprise Analytics Reporting. In many instances, Editorial Manager already includes standard reports that do not require any configuration of the type discussed in this video. Hovering the cursor over a report name without clicking it displays a set of icons to the left. Clicking the design icon allows you to use the standard reports as a starting point to edit and save a customized version of the report. Clicking the email icon allows you to send a report via email. Clicking the SFTP icon allows you to send the report results via SFTP. Clicking the Schedule a Report option allows you to schedule reports to be run and sent at some later time. You can also create or edit the delivery schedules at any time. Please contact your journal manager if you do not see this option and require account privileges to access it. When reports have been created or edited and then saved by the user, these will also display on the main menu in their own sections. Reports that are saved as individual level reports are accessible only to the report creator and listed in the My Reports section. Reports can also be shared with other users, and those that have been shared with you are listed in the Shared Reports section. If you want to create and save a new report, click on the Create Report link. When creating a new report or editing an existing report, you will be brought to the Report Designer interface. This interface displays a series of tabs that can be used to create or modify the report. Use the Data Sources tab to select your data source, which can be database tables or database views, from the available drop-down list. If more than one table or view is selected, they are automatically joined together on the common field using Inner Joined. This is a required step. When modifying an existing report, data sources will already be selected and in most cases can be retained. Use this Fields tab to select, change, or remove the fields or columns that should be displayed in the Final Reports section. Available fields are those included in the tables or views selected on the Data Sources tab. When fields are selected, each display as a column on the report, though they can be visually grouped and summarized into more complex layouts. This step also allows complex grouping such as arithmetic and pivot table functionality to be applied to the final data. This tab provides the most options for summarizing and formatting the text data in your final output. Use this Chart tab to configure a chart for your report to display data graphically in the form of plot, bar, pie, trend, funnel, etc. Use the Gorgeous tab to build dashboard-type displays to visualize critical performance data. Use the Miscellaneous tab to add a report title, report description, report header and footer to your data. This tab is also mainly used where access permissions are determined, whether this is a shared report available to all users or the report is configured only for your personal use. Use this style tab to change the colors of the report, the display order of the report elements such as the detailed report, summary report, chart, gorgeous, etc. Use the filters tab to set up selection criteria for the detailed reports. For example, use this tab to set up specified date ranges for a search or to limit a report to a specific term, such as a specific editor decision term. This is an optional step, though most reports will require one or more filters to exclude unwanted data. Filters can be further configured as parameters, which can be changed when the report is run. Use this preview button to view the report results during the design process without leaving the report design interface. Each tab also has a preview button that brings you to the preview tab. When preview is clicked, the first 1,000 results are displayed by default. You can reset the results drop-down to all if desired. Below the row of tabs is the toolbar containing some additional items such as New, Save, and Save As options, and these are not displayed on the Report Viewer toolbar. Use this New option to create a new report altogether. Use the Save option to save changes to the existing report under the same name. Please note that this button will only be available for reports that are saved with full access permission under the shared reports. Use the Save As option if you would like to save a copy of the report under a new name. To save a modified version of the standard report, click the Design button, make edits, then use the Save As button to save a copy. Each tab of the report design process allows you to configure different aspects of the report. Not every tab is required to create a successful report. Though there needs to be at least one report element configured, such as the fields, summary, chart, or gorge, to see any results on the preview tab. This is how you run the enterprise analytics reporting in Editorial Manager. Please visit the Journal Article Publishing Support Center should you require further information. Thank you for watching.